So first, to import any CSV file into the SQL, you have to create a database. If you want to use the same database, you can use, for example, here I will use a new database. I will create a database. I will write create database. Welcome back to my channel. Today, our topic is very interesting. Okay, one of our subscribers requests us to make a video on this topic. For example, you have a Excel file or CSV file and you want to import that into the SQL. And then you want to write a query there, then you have to create a visualization in or dashboard in another tool like Excel or Power BI or Tableau, whatever you want. We will understand everything about this, then how to import a CSV file into the Excel. Okay, so without any further delay, let's get it started. So first, to import any CSV file into the SQL, you have to create a database. If you want to use the same database, you can use, for example, here I will use a new database. I will create a database. I will write create database. I want to give a name. For example, you want to give name analytics. Okay, and I will just hit the control enter. So as you can see here, we have our database. There is a two way to import a data into the MySQL workbench. One, for example, you have a big data, like I have open here. See, you have a big data like this one. Okay, you can do one thing. First, what you will do, you have to create a table by the name of any, whatever name, and then you can create a column. Then you will import it. But there is a very easiest way. Choose your database wherever you want to create. Like, for example, in our case, we will choose the analytics. Okay, then what you have to do, just expand it and go to the table, right click on it, you will see an option of table data import wizard. From here, what you have to do, you have to choose your file. So click on the browse and select the file wherever you have saved. For example, I have saved my file into the download. So I will just click on it, but make sure your file is it in CSV form, not in Excel form. Otherwise, you won't be able to import that. Then simply click on next. From here, you can use a existing table also, and you can create a new table. So for now, I will create a new table. Click on next. Make sure you check the data type here. Sometime what happened, the data type doesn't match. So you can check out from here. All right. Then I will again go here and next. Here you don't have to select anything. Just click on next. Okay. So click on next, next, next and finish it. Now, if you will refresh it, you will be able to see your data into the your database, which is have you from like, you know, I will see select star from finance. Like that, you can import the another database also. Just click on table, import data and go to the browse, select your another file like before I select a finance one. Now I will select the finance two. Next, next, just click on next, 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 next. And yeah, there is one more thing. If your CSV file is very big, it maybe take a time to import data file. So don't you worry, just wait until it's finished. And then you just have to click on next and finish it. Your data will be in your SQL. All right, next and finish it. So now as you can see here, your both data is here, okay? And you simply can write your queries. And so that's it for today. Till then, happy learning, keep supporting, and don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you so much.